So I find it quite amusing that we're actually having this conversation. Let me set the stage for you. If you know California, then you know that the state flag has a bear in the middle of it. I think if you asked the majority of Californians, they'd say it was a black bear. It's actually a grizzly bear. Grizzly bears have been extirpated from California for quite some time. But California has a significant black bear population. See, today California is facing a wildlife management problem as it relates to its black bears. And likely this wildlife management problem was put in place by a decision back in 2012. This wildlife management problem with black bears can be considered a very good thing. It means you have an overabundant population of black bears. Now, the anti-proponents of this bill that's moving forward in California, AB 1038, Assembly Bill 1038, will say that we don't need to manage, we don't need to put our hands, human hands, on wildlife. Let Mother Nature do what she does. Let the wildlife do what they do. Well, that's a great argument and logically makes sense if we were living 100, 200, 300 years ago, in which California looked like a sea of wilderness with these pockets and islands of humanity, when today California is the poster child of a human-dominated landscape. You see, there is a sea of humans all the way through California, with these islands of wildlife habitat that are occupied by wildlife. And when you have too much wildlife in these pockets, they start spilling out of these pockets and interacting with the sea of humanity. And that's what's happening with black bears in California today. You've got to get past this idea that you can have infinite wildlife without any problems. Number one, you can't have infinite wildlife, especially today, in this human-dominated landscape I just discussed. Number two, you can't have large numbers of wildlife without having problems. And when I say problems, I mean human-wildlife conflict problems. And when it comes to a predator, like a black bear, those problems are exacerbated, in which people are afraid of black bears have no fear of humans, black bears get into trouble, they get into trash. You can't have infinite amount of bears that will lead to zero problems or issues with bears. What you want is the Game and Fish Agency of the respective state, so in this case, California Department of Fish and Wildlife, you want them to have the tools and the flexibility to be able to manage that wildlife for the people of the state and for the wildlife of the state. That's what AB 1038 wants to do. AB 1038 provides flexibility to California Department of Fish and Wildlife to manage black bears. Right off the bat, the opponents of AB 1038 will say that there are not enough black bears in the state of California. The population is too low. The science isn't there. CDFW arguably has the best black bear data of any state in the union. 3 years ago, when HSUS threw a bill with Senator Weiner out of San Francisco, challenged CDFW for its science around black bears and the legitimacy of a black bear hunt, little did they know that CDFW had been undertaking one of the largest black bear census studies in North America. And all you have to do is read the black bear management plan that got put on the street in 2024 for you to realize that California has an estimated 60 to 85,000 black bears. That's not a small amount of black bears. In fact, it's the opposite. Beyond the science of black bears, the opponents will attack the use of dogs because that's their favorite tactic when it comes to banning hunting. This is what happened in 2012. SB 1221 got rid of hound hunting for bears in the state of California because it's sick, because it's unethical, because it's not fair chase. Those are the arguments. You've heard it time and time and time again. And so what's happened since 2012? The black bear population has gone like this. The reason being is that the quota that's being set by CDFW for hunting has never been met, since hounds have not been used to chase black bears. AB 1038 is creating a very tightly regulated hound hazing mechanism to, number one, reduce human-wildlife conflict with black bears. AB 1038 is also increasing the flexibility for CDFW through science to determine whether or not it needs to increase its harvest of black bears, more than likely very geographically specific to the data. And the proven method to increase harvest is through the use of a very tightly regulated hound season for bears. The use of dogs is not this unsporting, unfair mechanism, but rather a very, very effective, efficient population management tool for reducing black bear numbers in specific geographies to then reduce human wildlife conflict in those areas. End of story. There has to be wildlife management occurring in a population that continues to grow, and one that continues to grow in a human-dominated landscape like California. AB 1038 gives the Department of Fish and Wildlife the flexibility to that management. It's imperative that they get that flexibility. So if you want to help, go to HAL. HAL, you'll see all of the action alerts in which you can have your voice heard and you can let everybody know what you think about AB 1038. To me, it's very straightforward. AB 1038 provides the state resource managers at CDFW the flexibility to manage wildlife. That can only be a good thing.